Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Kellen here from Start Your Systems, and welcome to Track Walk Episode 86 in MX Simulator, the 2016 Millville National, which is, I believe, round 8 of the Lucas Oil Pro Motocross Championship this weekend in Millville, Minnesota. And this track was built by Checkers, also known as Chris Riesenberg. He made the displacement for this track, and it was Race Carlin who did the decals, as usual, and SMR on the objects and statues placement again. And then wheels packaged it up for release by Race Factor Gaming. And I'd also like to announce that Glen Helen, finally available for public release to anybody that did not pay for the Race Factor Gaming membership. So a lot of people were up in arms about that. That link will now be included in the description for our track walk on Glen Helen, so you can go ahead and take a look back at that if you want. But we are going to talk about this track today, Millville, which pretty much has stayed the exact same as long as Sim's been around for the most part, except for the section coming up on this lap here, which is Mount Martin. They like kind of added a little extra bit at the top of the hill because the Martin brothers, Jeremy and Alex, their parents actually own this facility and live right on the property. So I think it was 2 years ago now they changed this section, so it used to turn left right about there, but now it just goes all the way up to the top of this hill in the trees and then up to a plateau and then turns around. It's a much longer downhill, and in Sim it's very rough and challenging, and in real life I'm sure it's just as much as the same. But you can see I kind of skid down this thing in first gear because I was just learning the track when recorded the making of the lap segment here at the end of the video. So not the best of laps this week, but we made do with what we could. And yeah, pretty much everything after that is straightforward. A couple switchback U-turns, and then this rhythm section, which used to have a couple big doubles in it, but now it's more of like a rhythm section. And then another little S-curve here with a big roller on the inside, and then up the other side of the valley. The only time you hit the other side of the valley, and then drop down into a right 90 into the finish line. So that is a lap at Millville. Go ahead and go on board with me and stick around for the making of the lap segment at the end. Alright guys, welcome back to the making of the lap segment here on Track Walk episode number 86, the 2016 Millville National in MX Simulator. And I may have already mentioned this, but just want to apologize for the late uploads again this week. That's pretty much back-to-back weeks. It will probably be uploading stuff on Saturday because we're so far behind. With Jeremy being so busy with work and that kind of going on, it's tough for him to get anything uploaded. And so when I have something go on in my life, we pretty much get nothing done. And this week, my girlfriend and I went to the Major League Baseball All-Star Game, which was a killer time, by the way. Would recommend if that ever comes to your city to go to that. However, it was quite expensive. I won't disclose how expensive the tickets that we paid for were. I'll just say that we were season ticket holders. We are, not were, are season ticket holders for the San Diego Padres. We have 40 games that we go to. Yeah, go Padres, or, you know, a lot of people are on here are going to be like, fuck baseball, or some of you may say root for the other team, whatever. I know we've got some Dodgers fans that watch, and, no beef, man. I'm not super fond of the Los Angeles Dodgers, but some of their fans are pretty cool, and every single one of you that are fans of the Dodgers are fans of me, so, I don't mind y'all one bit. Anywho, even with our season tickets to the Padres game, we got them at like this kind of MLB discounted rate because we were season ticket holders to the event, to the place that the event was being held at. And it was still pretty expensive for third deck seats. So if you do ever go to an MLB All-Star game, you may want to put aside some money, i.e. if it's coming to your city in the near future. We knew it was coming to San Diego, so before that we had made several plans to get season tickets and to have the money put aside to be able to go to the Major League Baseball All-Star Game. So we were planned and set and ready to go for that. So next year it's going to Miami, I believe, and then I'm not sure where it's going the year after that, but if you haven't been to an MLB All-Star Game yet, I would recommend it, but I'd also say be prepared to pay a lot of money. But yeah, I'm a big baseball fan of pretty much every team. I will watch a game if it's on TV, and I've been to several ballparks already, so definitely cool to see the All-Star Game come into San Diego and a bunch of people there. We went to my girlfriend and I went to the Fan Fest thing that they had on Monday, which was the same day that the Home Run Derby was on, and we went to the Home Run Derby as well. And we also went to, we did a 5K, it's called the Color Run, but it's basically a 5K, which is about 3.1 miles for those of you using the Imperial system. And it ran through the downtown streets of San Diego. You get these like kind of colored powder, if you, I don't really know what exactly it is, but because you're sweating while you're running, they throw it on you and this powder sticks to you, so that's why it's called the Color Run, because, well, the powder is it sticks to you and then you end up all colorful once you get to the finish line. So we did that, and that took a lot out of us, I would say. Didn't take a whole lot out of me. For those of you that don't really know, like, my backstory previous to this YouTube channel, I was a captain and also part of a league championship winning cross-country team in high school, and ran track and field for a year or two. Was less fond of that, but I'd like to consider myself a good runner. But my best friend Aaron, who you guys have seen do videos on this channel before, is a fantastic runner. He's won several half marathons and some 5Ks, local 5Ks. But he, I think his biggest accomplishment, if I could pick one out, was he won the Disneyland half marathon for his age group, which was, I think, 17 to 21 when he was 18 years old. It was pretty, at the time, I thought it was a pretty big deal. I think he finished, I want to say, like, eighth or so overall. And, I mean, that, like, that in itself is kind of crazy. It was somewhere in the eight to low teens overall. But that in itself, like I said, is crazy, because the people that run races like the Disneyland Half Marathon, which is a big deal, they, what am I trying to say here? They are elite athletes. Sometimes Olympic athletes will run those kind of events. So for Aaron to finish that high up at only age 18 just kind of shows you something special. I believe his official time was like 107 or so. Could be wrong, but he is a fast mofo. He can run long distance with low times in miles. Like a good mile to run in track and field is in the low fours. That's like a good time. A great time is under four. That is like getting close to record breaking. I'm pretty sure the world record for a mile on a track and field is like a 3:53, I want to say. So that's just to give you an idea that you have to run a mile pretty fast, and to run 13.1 miles in, you know, not much more than an hour. I don't, like I said, I don't remember the exact official time. But anyway, Aaron's a great runner, and we both have been running competitively at some point in our life. He's doing it now, I'm not doing it anymore. But a 5K doesn't take a whole lot out of me, even though I don't actively run or train anymore like I used to in high school. I can pretty much jog an entire 5K, no problem. But Hannah was a little less, how you say, acceptable with the 5K, and unfortunately she was kind of sore, like walking around and doing a bunch of stuff the next day and the day after that, which the next day after the 5K was the Home Run Derby, and the day after that was the All-Star Game, so walking around was less than ideal for both of us, really. I was kind of sore too, but we did the 5K. And then that later that day, we went and saw the MLB Futures game, which is basically like the best single A, double A, and triple A Major League Baseball affiliate athletes in their respective programs. And it's the USA versus the world team. All this stuff was on like ESPN and like the major networks. So if any of you watch it, you probably already know what I'm talking about. After that, we watched the celebrity game where they had like big name celebrities and legends. That's the man, I can't stop crashing on this track. I'll apologize in advance as I'm in mid story here, because I've had very limited time on the track this week, very limited time doing anything, because I mean, the All-Star game was just yesterday, and this is going to come out 2 days after the All-Star game. And so when you have a bunch of crap going on in the early times of the week, and the track's released on Monday. Actually, I believe it was released on Sunday. Last week, Southwick was released on Wednesday, and it pushed everything back for us. This week, the All-Star game pushed everything back for me. But everybody's all stupid fast on this track already, because they've had 3 days to put in on it, and I'm probably going in dry pretty much tomorrow night for the Nationals. So the 4.6 I put in at Southwick, probably not going to be repeated. Anyway, back to my All-Star game story. Went to the celebrity game, as I said. I'm trying to think of some big name celebrities that you guys may know. Terry Crews was there. Jamie Foxx was there. J.K. Simmons. They had like big name athletes there too, like Drew Brees was there, and then a lot of former, mostly somewhat, I think, either Hall of Fame or big name Padre baseball players. Trevor Hoffman was there. Ozzie Smith was there. David Wells, just big baseball legends and so on and so forth. But it was a fun experience, that was. And then the next day we went to FanFest, as I said. We were there most of the afternoon, and then the Home Run Derby started at 5. So the Home Run Derby was like 5 to 7. Went to that. That was hella fun, watching people literally just smoke balls out of the yard, swing after swing. Giancarlo Stanton is a beast. And then All-Star game on Tuesday, we went down there early. We watched the parade of players. So we watched pretty much every All-Star player go through the streets of San Diego on the back of these cars, makeshift, or their trucks actually, and they had like the players' names and all that stuff on it. And it was just a cool thing. Like, the All-Star game was super fun to watch. You know, it's just, I think something like that, we're baseball fans already, but even if you're not a baseball fan, like being able to experience something like that, I think it's pretty cool. I would say it's not quite the same thing as going to a World Series for a Major League Baseball game. Padres haven't been in it since 98, but even so, I think I'd still prefer to go to like a World Series game that a different team was featured in. So that might be something that Hannah and I do in the future. Even if the Padres don't make it, that's probably something that'll cross our bucket list because we're big baseball fans, as I said. So even if the Padres don't make it, we'd like to see other teams play. But the All-Star game is like, trying to think what it would be comparable to. It's, you know, it's sort of like a thing like going to the Super Bowl where it's unique. It jumps around cities, and I say it's like the Super Bowl because the Super Bowl, it's like a city is selected as the Super Bowl host, and then the teams qualify to go to the Super Bowl. Not like the World Series or the NBA Finals where the home teams each have like games at their home stadium. Like, it's a complete arbitrary thing. It has nothing to do with the Padres doing well that they get to host the All-Star game or anything like that. It's a total bid thing where the city bids on it. And so, like I said, it's kind of, I feel like it's equivalent, but not really, to going to the Super Bowl in the way that it's set up. But it's like a once in a lifetime experience kind of thing where you can say, yeah, I went to the Major League Baseball All-Star game at San Diego in 2016. Like, the last time it was in San Diego was 1992. So I wasn't even born yet the last time it was here. It was just a great experience, and like I said, I'd recommend it. Even if you're not a baseball fan, they find ways to get people involved, which I think was really cool. There's a lot of different things that you could do. The Fan Fest, I think people would find pretty unique. Even if you're not baseball fans, there's things that you can do there that don't even have to do with baseball. A lot of it does, obviously, but you can, you know, there's a lot of different cool events and stuff like that. So, it's not like we're doing a sponsored video. I'm just saying that my experience was fun and that I'd recommend it. So, that's why we were kind of so behind on uploads this week. That's why Track Walk is coming out on a Thursday. That's why apparently my setup on this track is garbage because I cannot run a lap. But I guess I'll have to figure that out tonight as soon as I'm done making this video and I get to get online and actually play with my friends and figure out what's wrong with my setup. But I'm pretty sure I'm going into this race tomorrow night and I'm going to be riding like poop. So that's no fun. But on a side note, I think Millville is actually a pretty sick track. Like, IRL, it's a great track. I'm really glad that the series goes there every year. It's cool that the Martin Bros and the Martin family owns the facility, so it's really a home race for them. It's a good track. It's a unique track because, as I've heard it described, I've never been there obviously, but seeing how it races and as I've heard it described, it's like a sand without being a sand, if that makes sense. Like, the top of the track, the very base level of the track. Not the base level, what am I trying to say here? The topsoil, if you will, of the track is like a sand. So ruts will form based around that sand, but the base of the track is very hard, which is why you see a lot of rough, and it gets like a really rugged surface every year. I've seen some big get-offs because of head shake on this track, which only means that the rough is really, really choppy. You don't see head shake in sand, sand like on a Southwick. You don't see people getting massive head shake and then yard sailing unless they're like complete beginners and don't know what to do with their hands. But you know, we've seen Roczen got spit off real hard in 2013, I think, when he was battling Eli Tomac for the outdoor championship on this track. Of course, everybody remembers Chad Reed and the Chatapult incident, where on this jump actually coming up right here, he was just kind of swinging around and leaning off the front of the bike, and then the front end caught, and he launched off to the left there. All that stuff just kind of leads me to believe that the base of the track is actually very hard, because once all those bumps form, that top layer of sand doesn't really do anything. Like, it's just, like I said, a top layer of sand, so... feel like the base is very hard. It's got a lot of crazy chop to it, and it feels like the track builders have built it to that specification where the base has those really rough and tumble kind of things. So that's cool that the track makers did that this week, and I'm just having a real tough time on these downhills, so I'm just going first gear all the way down. So let's see, this lap feels all right. It's not going to be an on fire lap, but if I can get in like the 210-ish range, I'll be satisfied enough with that, and that'll be the lap that we run. Pretty much, it looks like the fast times on this track this week are in like the 2 flat to 202 range. Like 2 flat is like alien speed, but almost everybody else beyond that is in like the 205s. So that's just what I've seen so far. This lap is a pretty good lap as long as I make it through the last corner, and a 215, pretty shitty lap, but at least I finished one, and that's what you guys are going to have to deal with this week because I am done. But anyway, thank you guys for watching Track Walk episode 86 here on Start Your Systems. I hope you guys enjoyed my spiel about the MLB All-Star Game in San Diego this week. If you like this video, you can go ahead and hit it with a like. You can comment any of your questions or concerns, and we'll be happy to get back to you as soon as we can. And if you haven't already, I'd recommend subscribing to the channel. I'm a little biased with my recommendation, but I think we have some good stuff going on here. And it's all for the fans, all for you guys, so we love hearing your comments and concerns and trying to build off of that. Thanks you guys for watching this episode of Track Walk. For Kellen Brower on Start Your Systems, we'll catch you guys next time.